Hello students, in this video we will be discussing about how to format a document in LibreOffice Writer. Okay, before that we should be very clear about what is a formatting. As you can see that we are having a document which is not well formatted. Everything is written jumbly, not in a proper format. Okay, so we will discuss that how we can format, what are the different formatting features that we can apply and from where to get all those features in LibreOffice Writer. Okay, we should be very clear about what is formatting. First of all, formatting basically means to change the overall look of a document. Formatting means applying special kind of features, like we can apply borders, we can apply font colors, we can apply different fonts, bold, italic, all these kind of effects if we are going to apply to a document to make it more presentable and readable. Although those features comes under formatting features. As we all know that in LibreOffice Writer interface, we are having this toolbar as the formatting toolbar, this one. These all options are for the formatting. So that means if we are applying any of these features, like for the font, font size, bold, italic, underline, strike through, so many features. So these all come under the formatting of the document. Okay. For example, I just now we will discuss about the different types of formatting. First of all, there are different types of formatting. For example, if I want to format a text specifically, the formatting for the paragraph, the formatting for the page. So we will be discussing these type of formatting in this content. Basically, for today, for this video, we are going to focus on text formatting. Right? When we go for text formatting, there are different types of formatting. But before going to the text formatting, we should be ready with a document. We should have a proper page format. That means proper margin and all. Okay. Then we will cover the text formatting. Like it can be done from different options. I'll tell you. First, we will go for the page style dialog box. See, now when we are going to create a new document, we have to do the page settings first of all. Okay. So for that, we have to go to the format menu. See, this format menu is going to provide us all the features regarding the formatting of the document. We can find here different options. See, these some of the options are same here listed in the formatting toolbar, like text is there, spacing, align, list. So these features are listed in the format menu as well as in the formatting toolbar here itself. Okay, so first, as we are talking about page style dialog box, so we have to go to the format menu, then we have to go to the page option. Okay, format menu, and we have to go to the page option, then we will be able to open the dialog box of page style. Fine, this is the dialog box for page style. This is going to give us the feature. We will go under the option page here. Right, then this feature will give us, see here, we can have page format, like we are having the different format. We can choose from here the width of the page that for we are working, height, orientation. Basically, we are having two types of orientation for a document. One is a portrait one, other is a landscape one. Right now we have selected the portrait. If we are going to have a landscape orientation, it will be changed like width wise. Normally the we are working on portrait one. The margins, as we can see that for all, we are having four type of margins: left, right, top and bottom. Basically the basic value that is selected for all is 2 cm. If I want to change, I want to increase the value, I can increase from here, suppose 2.30 cm or 2.50 cm for the left margin. Fine, and for the right and all, if let it be same right now. Okay, so from here I can change it. Then I'm having the option from here, page layout. Fine, these are the different options, page numbers. If I want to display in any pattern, these are the options which I can go for. Okay, so this way, whatever the settings I have done, I want to just click on apply and then okay. Fine, this way our margins have been changed. Now the next thing is about text formatting. Now when we go for text formatting, as we can see here, there is other different types of text formatting. I can do it from the format menu. See, from format menu, so many options are given here. Fine, the second one is using formatting toolbar. These formatting options are given in this toolbar. One by one we can go, and according to the requirement we can apply. Then using the context menu, is when we are going to go for the right click. We can find an option over here, character. these are the options that are displayed here. So we can go for any option to have the formatting. Fine. Then the next option is character dialog box. This character dialog box, I can go from the format menu and I can click on the option character over here. Then one dialog box will open in front of me. That is for the character dialog box. From here I can select for border. This one is for font. Font effects, what color I want for the font, and overlining, strike through, underlining, case, capital case, lower case, fine. So these kind of effects are there, embossed, engraved, blinking, shadow. So whatever the thing I want to change regarding the font, that I can do from here. Position of the text, hyperlink and all. So basically formatting mein we will go for the font effects, font and borders, etc. Okay, so the next is this. Then properties pane. Properties pane is here, provided here in LibreWriter at the extreme right end. When we'll click on this properties, we can have a wide display of all these formatting features for the text. Like here, from here I can get for style, then for character, font and all. See, the same effects as are listed in the formatting toolbar are here also. So from either of the way, the options are same, their effects will also be same. These are the ways through which I am accessing these features. These are the effects for paragraph formatting. So right now we are going for text one, so we will focus on this area only. Okay, then keyboard shortcuts are there. We are having different shortcuts. Like for example, I want to have this text at the center. So I can have at bold effect. So I can go for the Control B option. Fine. If I have to go for the central alignment, this shortcut I can see from here also. When I will scroll my mouse, the shortcut is provided as Control plus E. So with the help of this shortcut, I can go for underline. Control U, I can have the underline, and Control E for the central alignment. Fine. So you can see that the moment I have applied these formatting options, these are highlighted also in formatting toolbar as well as in the properties. They are shown with the light blue shade. So I can get that these three formattings I have applied on my document. Okay. Now the next thing, there is one option of clear direct formatting. See this one, and the shortcut for this is Control plus M. Basically this feature is used in that case in which we are copying some text for somewhere. What happens, you might have also felt it, that whenever we are going to copy a text from either Google, from any website or all, so the effect of that text also copied, right? Now if I want to apply any formatting to it, so for that I have to clear it, the formatting already done. Okay, so for that I'm having the option of clear direct formatting. You can see here, as I'm clicking on clear direct formatting, all the formatting effect that I have applied on my text have been removed, right? So this way I can apply this remove manual formatting option. Now the common text formatting option basically comes for the first one to change the font. From here I can change the font. Okay, these are the different styles for the one, and font is right now I have selected Liberation Serif. Right? From here also I can change, from here also I can change. All the same options. We have discussed here these six options to work upon with the text formatting. Right? Either of the way we are going to do, the same things will happen. Whatever the font is suitable, we can go for that. See, this is the font that is not readable to us, so we can go for the Arial one. Fine. Now the next one, changing font size. Here also the same option. Right now we have selected the font as 12. Now 14, suppose I have selected bold, italic feature, we can apply. See, these features are getting highlighted. Underline, fine. Strike through, if you want a text to be striked, fine. Right now it is not suitable for the heading, so we can undo. Fine. If we want to change the color of the font, this option is for font color. Right now it is selected as red. Whatever color you want to have, you will click on this small triangle. It will give you a variety of options. We can go from there. Right? Now the next option is about this character spacing. See, the space between character between different characters in a word is also fixed. Very tight. See the difference. All the characters are now tightly packed. Tight. Fine. And normal one. This is the normal one. If we are going to have loose spacing between characters, so you can see the space, increased space between the characters, very loose like this. So obviously we prefer the normal one. But in some cases, if we want to increase or decrease the space between them, so we can go for this option. This is called as the character spacing option. Now, increase font size and decrease font size, we are having the shortcut also for them. Fine, we can go from here, control, see, we can find, and we are having this arrow. Up-headed arrow will be for the increasing one, and this down-headed arrow will be for the decreasing one. The icon is for square brackets, control plus ending square bracket and control plus starting small bracket, you can go for that, right? So these are the things from where we can directly increase or decrease the size of the font. Suppose I have selected this heading and I want to increase the font size from here directly. See, this way we can increase. And suppose I want to decrease some one, I can go for this. Like this, it can be decreased, right? Now, the next one is about superscript and subscript. There is an option of superscript and subscript. Now, as you all must be knowing that superscript is basically the raised to the power. And subscript is like we write the formula in chemistry like H2O2, fine? For that, we are having the shortcut here as Ctrl+Shift+P for the superscript, Ctrl+Shift+B for the subscript. Same options are provided here as well, along with the same shortcut. Suppose I am writing here one formula like X². So this 2 I need to select and I can directly go with the option, this one. Fine? Or either I can use the shortcut. Suppose I want to write H2. Again, I have to click to deactivate this feature. Suppose I want to write now the formula for H2O. Okay. Now this 2 needs to be added in the subscript mode. So this way I can write it. Again, but you have to come out of it. So we have to click it again. Okay. Now the next option is how to change the case of the text. Like we are having small case and text, small case, capital case and all. So for that, suppose this text I have written here, I want to capitalize this text. So what I need to do, there are different options. Fine. I can first of all go to the format menu, then I can find the option text, and automatically it has changed here. Fine. Now one more option, if I'll go from the context menu, just select the text, fine, character, fine. Now see here, when we go for the font FX1, here is the option for case, fine. Now capitals, lowercase, title case, small capital. So these are the different options for changing the case. If I'll go for all capitals, it will be showing the same one. Capital cases, fine. You can see in the preview, lowercase, all cases in lower one. Title case is this one. And small capitals like this. Small capitals means the first letter of every word has been, it is capital, but smaller in size comparatively, fine. So these are the different options how we can go for the cases, change in cases. If I want to have a blinking effect, I can see from the preview, fine. Overlining, single, suppose this is the overline, that means the line above the document. Underlining, if I want to have double, bold or dotted underline for a particular text, I can have it. So these are the preview, these are the effects which I have applied right now, fine. So in this way, we can work with the text formatting options. I hope that all these features you will be able to apply properly, fine. Thank you, everyone.